Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel and welcome to the day two of the year and quiz fest. So here me Rajib Ulawal with the quiz 2020. So all the happenings and the related happenings of the year 2020 will be here. So here we go with the quiz 2020. We had a great participation in yesterday's quiz, that is India quiz by Shashanko. So hear me Rajib Lal with the quiz 2020. Rules remain the same, times remain the same. We are going to start now and you have to submit the answer within 9 p.m. Today the number of question is 19. Yesterday it was 18. Today the number of question is 19. And same marking pattern, plus 10 for each correct answer. For two part answers, we will give 5 plus 5. So here we go with the questions. Question number one. So question number one, Varun Tandon, a visual artist from Chandigarh, paid tribute to Mahashay Dharampal Gulati after his death by doing this portrait. You can see this portrait. So this portrait is by Varun Tandon. He's a visual artist from Chandigarh. He prayed tribute to Mahashay Dharampal Gulati. So simply tell me with the help of what this portrait was done. So something special was used to make this portrait. So what something special? If you know the background of Mahashay Dharampal Gulati, it would be very easy to crack this answer. I'm looking for a very specific answer. So if you know the background of Mahashay Dharampal Gulati, you will know what this could be. You can see the color, that is a giveaway hint. So Varun Tandon made this portrait with the help of what? As simple as that. So here we go with the question number one. So now moving on to question number two. Easy one, named after which Nobel laureate? So who named after which Nobel laureate is what I'm looking for. This is a basically a tiling. So tiling. So this tiling is called something tiling, dash tiling. So what tiling it is called? I said Nobel laureate. The quiz is 2020. So it would be very easy to guess what it can be. So named after which? Remember again, this is quiz 2020. So and I asked, named after which Nobel laureate? So that would be a giveaway hint. So which Nobel laureate? I'll give you some time for this question. Just view the photo and just take a guess. This tiling is named after which Nobel laureate? Moving on to next question, question number three. Easy one, which brand is this? You can see a logo. As of Feb 2020, after the start of COVID-19 pandemic, it suffered a huge loss in earning. The company attributed the sales drop to fewer people going out in public, with many bars and restaurants being forced to close. However, in December 2020, the Guardian reported that 2020 sales of its had an increase of about 40% in UK supermarket compared to 2019. So which brand is this? It said that it got a huge drop in 2020 sales. Again, in December 2020, the Guardian reported that 2020 sales of it had increased of about 40% in UK supermarket compared to 2000. So these are the business sector of this particular brand. So if you need hint, think about 2020. The first thing that should come into your mind, maybe the reason why you are at home till now, or you are working from home, is what the answer is. So which brand is this? Easy one. Moving to question number four. Monkey Day is an unofficial international holiday celebrated on December 14. So the holiday was created and popularized in 2000 by artists Kashi Choro and Eric Milliken when they were art students at Michigan State University. Probably coincidence at its best, this year something happened worldwide to show everyone a monkey on the Monkey Day. So how or explain? So I said, probably coincidence at its best, or it was designed, so I don't know. But if this was a coincidence, so it would be a coincidence at its best. This year, something happened worldwide to show everyone a monkey on the Monkey Day. So how, or simply explain? So December 14, very recent, something happened. Everyone saw monkey on Monkey Day. So this is the history of Monkey Day, and I said coincidence this year. So this year, December, something happened worldwide to show everyone a monkey on the Monkey Day. So simply what you need to say is why everyone saw monkey, or simply explain. Question number five. Easy one. Name the opponent of Hallinen. So this is he is Terence Hallinen advanced with a 37% vote majority to a general election for district attorney of San Francisco, but failed to win the election, with thus his dream to be district attorney of San Francisco was shattered. His opponent, who won the seat of district attorney that year, was in news in some part of 2020. So whoever was his opponent was in news in some part of 2020. So who was the opponent of Hallinen, where Hallinen's advanced with 37% of vote majority to general election for district attorney of San Francisco? So who was the opponent of Terence Hallinen? Easy one. Since politics and 2020, probably you can guess the answer. Moving on to question number six. Question number six, he declined to play in 2000. He was getting married in the off season, and Chris Ballard of Sports Illustrated described one of the most famous move, as a jab, stab, and pause. Something tragic that happened while traveling from John Wayne Airport, which shocked the whole world. So identify the person. So a particular tragic incident that happened when he was traveling from John Wayne Airport to a specific destination, something happened. So who is this person? Identify the person who was traveling from John Wayne Airport, and it shook the whole world. It shocked the whole world. So identify the person in the question. So he declined to play the 2000 Olympic because he was getting married in the off season. So who is this? Without wasting any time, moving on to question number seven. Easy one. Identify the city where this clock tower is located. In bracket, I told, I bet you all have came across the name of the city in 2020. I didn't say that you probably have seen this clock tower, but I can bet you all have came across the name of the city in 2020. So some specific reason behind that. So identify the city where this clock tower is located. So I just name the city. I'm not looking for how you came across the name in 2020, but simply tell the name of the city where this clock tower is located. You can have a key look at the image. So simply tell me which city. Moving on to question number eight. The person you see here is Indulal Yagnik, a leader of Mahagujarat Andolan. What fort of time did he introduce in the 50s that was regained into prominence in 2020? So something regained its prominence in 2020. It was first time introduced in 50s. So he introduced in 1950s, and it gained its prominence in 2020. So what was the thing he introduced in 1950s? So this person is a leader of Mahagujarat Andolan. He introduced something in 1950s, and it regained into prominence in 2020. Somewhere in the middle of 2020, think about something that was happening all around. And another one more restriction you can say. So what restriction I'm looking for? So what regained in prominence in 2020? Simple one. Moving on, question number 9. Easy to identify the person and explain the context. You can see a person wearing mask with different names on it. So who is this person? And explain the context. I'm not looking for the sports event or anything like that, but I'm looking for the context and the name of the person. So why those and who is this person? So two part answer, 5 plus 5. Easy one, name the name this person and explain the context. Moving on to question number 10. Probably easiest of all, Go India is a virtual game on that that allows you to visit cities across India. This can be done with a combination of city tickets and kilometers, which you earn by making payments or recharge and sharing or asking a friend. User who visited all 30 cities before December 26, the win Go India champion reward of rupees 101 to 501. So which app is this, which was giving to the champion rupees 101 to rupees 501? So it's a virtual game. So you can visit really to the different cities in the map. So Go India is a virtual game by which app? As in that, this is the context and what exactly Go India is. I'm looking for the name of the app with, under which the this Go India game was played. It said making payments or recharge and sharing to or asking a friend. So that particular line can be a giveaway hint. So probably easiest of all, won't waste much of time in this question. So which app is this? Probably 50% or more than of you have tried this game as well. So probably the easiest of all. Moving to question number 11, halfway down. He's a well-known naturalist and a destination manager of a cruise. This person came into limelight due to something he did in his field recently, as in somewhere around 2020, which had been across the social media as well as in the electronic media. Basically, you probably have seen his field or work on his particular field in the social media. Probably in your WhatsApp status, probably in the WhatsApp groups, probably in the Facebook pages. I don't need his name. Simply tell because of what he came into limelight. So well-known naturalist, that can be a giveaway hint. So who is this person? Not looking for the name of the person, but looking for his contribution, which had been across the social media and electronic media as well. So what was the reason of his limelight? As simple as that. Moving to question number 12. Who is she and how we know her as? I had no idea that this thing is going to become so viral and so many people are going to react to it. It has been beyond my imagination, to be frank. It is not very usual experience for a voice over artist to get it get this kind of reaction or recognition. She told so Times Now. So this was his this was her reply to the journalist of Times Now. So you can see the image. So simply tell who is she and how we know her as. He told that she had no idea that she would become so popular. It was her beyond her imagination. And it is given that for a voiceover artist like her. So it is not very usual experience for a voiceover artist to get this kind of reaction or recognition or attention. So who is she and how we know her as? For the second part, I would give a clue. So probably the most irritating thing in the 2020 can be a government. So most irritating thing that you can find in 2020 is her voice. So who is she and how we know her as? 5 plus 5. For the second part, I gave clue that the most annoying voice of 2020. Moving to question number 13. Easy one, what was this match all about? It said 9 February 2020 and it was versus Ponting 11 versus Gilchrist 11. So probably you can see the geography and where you can see Bryn Lara scoring 30 of 11, Shane Watson scoring 30 of 9. And finally Ponting 11 won by 1 run, which happened in Junction Oval, Melbourne, and Mel Jones was the umpire. So what was this match all about? Considering the date and the geography, you can make a direct guess and that would be correct. So what was this match all about? Somewhere here and there, I will give you points, even if you don't give the exact answer, but you are giving me the funda, that will be for full points. So funda as in the geography. And if you know what happened on that date, that would be a giveaway hint. So probably one of the easy question in this quiz. So what was that about? Too much of clue question. Now question number 14. Identify the company in question. I'm repeating again, identify the company in question. The lockdown was very fruitful for this particular company as the product Dash, so particular product, it triggered the highest sales in the month of March, April and May 2020, breaking the sales record of the last 8 decades from the time of its inception. The 5 rupees chotu pack came handy for many migrants who walked miles to get back home. Many volunteers and philanthropists distributed them in shack full to needy. The overall market share increased by 5%, and 80% to 90% of this came from the sale of this particular product. This was the unprecedented sick category head of company. So this was unprecedented. It was said by the category head of the company. So I am looking for the name of the company. I repeat, I am looking for the name of the company. So a particular product recorded the highest sale. And you can see in this second paragraph, the 5 rupees chotu packs came handy for many migrants who walked miles to get back home. Many volunteers and philanthropists distributed them in sack full of this to the needy. So that can be a giveaway. So 5 rupees chotu pack distributed by volunteers and philanthropists. And the overall market share increased by 5%. And out of those 5%, 80 to 90% of this came from this particular product. I'm not looking for the name of the product, simply name the company. I'm repeating, I need the name of the company. Question number 15. This bright green installation made headlines in 2020 when it toured the second largest city of Czech Republic, appearing in several landmarks across the town over a period of 2 weeks. What is this peculiar piece of public art attribute to? So you can see a bright green installation made, you can see in image, there's bright green installation. So it made headlines when it toured the second largest city of Czech Republic. So what is this peculiar piece of public art attribute to? So simple one, if you know द ग्रीन बॉल्स और ग्रीन इंस्टॉलेशन, द शेप ऑफ इट, यू वुड क्रैक दिस आंसर इजिली. सो फॉर क्लूज आई कैन से समथिंग फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बायोलॉजी, एंड दैट मच आई कैन गिव यू क्लू, नॉट मोर देन दैट. समथिंग फ्रॉम द वर्ल्ड ऑफ बायोलॉजी, ग्रीन स्फीयर, ग्रीन इंस्टॉलेशन, एंड वॉट इज दिस ट्रिब्यूट टू, दैट इज वॉट आई एम लुकिंग फॉर. क्वेश्चन नंबर 16. As a footballer, he rose through the junior division of River Plate in the early 1970s when his position of attacking midfielder was covered by Norberto Alonso. His style reflected Alonso's with the emphasis on individual technique and short passes. His slow pace gained him the nickname of Pocaro, which is basically Spanish for slow coach. Identify this legend whom we lost in the end of 2020. So, who is this legendary person whom we lost in the end of 2020? So, as a footballer, he rose through the junior division of River Plate in the early 1970s when his position of attacking midfielder was covered by Norberto Alonso. So, who is this person, legendary person? His slow pace gained him the nickname of Pocaro or Pocharo, however it is pronounced, basically Spanish for slow coach. Slow coach. So, moving to the last few questions of the quiz, question number 17. Where you can see this photo in the context of 2020. So, simple. Where you can see this photo in the context of 2020. So this is, you don't know, you don't know. So I don't want to give much of hints in this question. So where can you see this photo in the context of 2020? Something was achieved in 2020, and this photo was part of it. So what thing? I can't give more clue, otherwise the answer will be out. Moving on to the penultimate question of the quiz. Question number 18. So, he's a South Korean actor who visited an eatery in Macau where he was served a kind of beverage reminding him of a type of Korean honeycomb toffee and later presented on a South Korean TV show called Star's Top Recipe at Funstrond. Which beverage am I talking about? So, South Korean actor visited an eatery in Macau where he was served a kind of beverage reminding him a type of South Korean, so basically Korean honeycomb toffee. So he later presented on a South Korean TV show called Star's Top Recipe at Funstrond. So which beverage am I talking about? When it comes to beverage in 2020, probably this could be the first thing that should come in your mind. So first thing that should come in your mind when we talk about beverage and 2020. So, which beverage am I talking about? South Korean actor visited eatery in Macau. Also, there's a clue given that honeycomb toffee. So, question number 18 is done. Now we will have the question number 19. Before moving on to question number 19, thanks for watching the full video. And submit your answers within 9 p.m. And if you haven't subscribed the channel, do subscribe the channel, like the video and share with your friends. Let them know about this channel and let the knowledge grow. So here we go with the question number 19. So this is a 2006 English movie, English language drama film directed by Meera Nair and written by Sunit Tarapurwala, based on a novel by Jhumpa Lahiri. Which actor played the role of Ashok Ganguly in this particular movie? So looking for the actor who played the role of Ashok Ganguly in this movie. So I'm not looking for the name of the movie. I'm looking for the actor who played the role of Ashok Ganguly in this movie. And this is the last question of the quiz 2020. And this is a tribute question to my favorite actor. So, who is the actor who played the role of Ashok Ganguly in this movie? So, this is 2006 English language drama film directed by Meera Nair. As simple as that, who played the actor who played the role of Ashok Ganguly in this movie? So that's all from our side. Thank you. And do share with your friends, subscribe the channel. And if you have joined in the middle, you can watch the video again from the beginning after the premiere is over. Thank you.